A large part of material heritage in India are works of art or art collections. Comprising paintings, sculptures, manuscripts, textiles, etc. that are housed in museums, galleries, and in private spaces. These document time periods in our vast history, representing the diverse culture that is India. The INTACH Conservation Institute, or ICI, envisions bringing art conservation and preservation to grassroots levels by creating state-of-the-art conservation laboratories with highly trained professionals.
The Art and Material Heritage Division of INTACH was started in 1985. The basic purpose of conservation is to understand the material science, the art objects, what are they made of, what is the chemical composition of any artifact, why does it deteriorate, what is the effect of light, what is the effect of temperature, what is the effect of heat, humidity. We need to understand scientifically why an art object is getting deteriorated, and then as a doctor or a surgeon would do for a human being, we need to intervene into the art object and increase its life. So it's basically the science which is involved in art.
We give credit to Dr. O.P. Agarwal. He pioneered the movement of conservation in the country and established various conservation centers across India.
The first INTACH Art Conservation Center was established in Lucknow in 1985. Over a period of time, a network of conservation centers have been established in different parts of India, functioning collectively as the INTACH Conservation Institutes.
Our main centers are located at Lucknow, Delhi, Bhubaneswar, Bangalore, and Kolkata. Apart from this, we've also helped various institutions establish their own conservation centers, like the Bhau Dajilad Museum at Mumbai, the Mehrangarh Museum Trust at Jodhpur, the Raza Library at Rampur and Jaipur.
We have done a lot of remarkable projects in past. The most important being very recent is the establishment of a maritime museum at Jobra in Cuttack. It was a defunct boat repair workshop which the Chief Minister wanted to make it into a maritime museum.
This museum reflects the maritime history of Orissa. It depicts different kind of boats and also cultural similarities between different countries. Its trade links with Southeast Asian countries. We have showcased various intangible aspects like the rituals which were followed before the Bali Yatra.
And it was a dedicated effort of about 4 years which took us to establish this museum, which is the largest in the country, I would say.
Since the subject of the museum is related to water, marine, we have also established a large aquarium here housing native fishes.
Over the years, we have developed expertise in undertaking conservation of varied art forms. Some specific examples are Bhutna Temple in Mandi, where the temple of 16th century was overpainted with a lot of garish enamel colors. And our conservation team, after doing a lot of scientific research, undertook the removal of all those paints and beautiful carvings earlier times were revealed.
ICI is working with various monasteries in Ladakh region, including the earliest one of 12th century at Mangyu. There is one of 17th century at Chemre and the latest 19th century at Bodhkharbu. These have beautiful yet very fragile wall paintings on mud plaster. The harsh conditions of the region add to the serious challenges of conservation and also limit the working time to only 4 months in a year. We therefore also involve capacity building at local level, including monks, which is to ensure maintenance of art once the projects are completed or handed over. The official residence of the President of India, the Rashtrapati Bhavan, has an impressive collection of art. INTACH has been undertaking conservation of these objects. Presently, we have been entrusted with the task of preparing a comprehensive conservation management plan, which includes documentation of the entire collection. One of the very important projects of INTACH, which is also self-financed, is the documentation of wall paintings in India. People only know the famous ones like Ajanta. There are many more and much more beautiful paintings which sadly are getting damaged and destroyed at a very fast pace because of our ignorance. Our project therefore aims at documentation of each and every wall painting of India. We will publish this, get it notified, and bring it to public domain so that they are protected, preserved, and cherished.
Apart from active conservation, the focus is to provide training to the youth so that the vast wealth of Indian heritage is preserved for future generations.
We've been conducting a lot of training programs because the fact is that India has a wealth of artifacts, and to conserve them in scientific manner, the conservators are very few. Students who are doing internships in different fields. Some people are working in wood, some people are working in stone, some are working in wall painting, some in paper, some in paintings. Secondly, one major step that we've initiated since last year has been to target the people who are working in government departments and who generate archives. Say, for example, the revenue department, the prison department, the collectorate, the courts, where there are hundreds and hundreds, thousands of documents which are being produced every day. So if we are able to educate the people who are responsible for making those files, you know, right from childbirth till death, there are records. And if people are able to conserve those records at that very stage, but eventually it will become a national movement. So as a mandate, we are trying to generate as many professionals as possible. And INTACH is one of the platforms where after studying conservation, to students come and they do internship in different conservation, different art forms.
Today we are recognized as the largest network of conservation centers in the world.
All the good conservators in India who have made an international representation are all from INTACH as of now. And this is a remarkable achievement that we have made.
Study and research, providing best quality conservation treatments to varied forms of art objects ranging from paintings, textiles, paper manuscripts, wall paintings, sculptures, etc. Unmatched services in conservation for art collectors to preserve our heritage for future generations.